Today we are going to study about the population genetics and Hardy-Weinberg principle or Hardy-Weinberg law. Population genetics and now, before discussing about the population genetics and Hardy-Weinberg law, I would like to explain some of the terminologies regarding the population genetics, the terms which are being used in these in this topic. We will discuss that. The first one is gene pool. What do you mean by gene pool? It means the total number of genes which are present in a given population, that is called as gene pool. Total number of genes matlab ki jitne bhi genes hain that which are present in the one population, ek population mein total jitne genes present hain, that is called as gene pool. Total number of genes present in a given population, that is called as gene pool. Suppose that if we have given a population, of bird. Say that in that population of bird there are 100 birds and each bird contains 10 genes. We have given a population of 100 birds and each bird contains 10 genes. So, what is the gene pool of this population? What might be the gene pool of this population? 10 into 100. Gene pool of this population will be 10 into 100. That is, number of genes that are present in one individual multiplied by the total number of individuals that are present in one population or that are present in that given population. So, here the total number of genes or the genes present in one individual or the one bird are 10 genes. 10 genes are present in the one bird and the population is of 100 birds. So, the gene pool will be 1000. The gene pool of 100 birds containing 10 genes individually. So, say as that the gene pool of this kind of population will be the 1000. So, this is gene pool. Next, what are genes? These are the genetic material. Genes are the genetic material and the smallest unit of the hereditary. Genes are the smallest unit of the hereditary. Now, the next is alleles. What are alleles? These alleles are alternative forms of the genes. alternative forms of the genes. Alternative forms of the genes that are present at the same place on the chromosome. Alleles are the alternative forms of the genes that are present at the same place on the chromosomes. Say that this is one chromosome, this is the centromere, and this is another chromosome, and these are the genes or the locus points, genes. This is one chromosome and this is another chromosome. These are the genes. Say that in this chromosome the genes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here B, C, D, E, and F. So these are the chromosomes, and the genes which are coming from the father, that are called as paternal genes. And the genes which are coming from the mother, that are called as maternal genes. So these are the genes which are present on the chromosomes. And the we have talked that alternative forms of the alleles that are present on the same place on the chromosome. So these alleles, these are present on the same place on the chromosomes, these are called as alleles. So, and the alleles which are present on the same locus, this is the one locus and this is the same locus, they are present on the same type of locus, these are called as allelic genes. And the alleles which are present on the different locus, like this, one allele is on the second number and one allele is on the third number. In the two chromosomes, one is present at the second number and another one is present at the third number. So this type of alleles are called as non-allelic genes. This type of genes are called as non-allelic genes. And alleles are present on the homologous chromosomes. What are homologous chromosomes? The chromosomes which are morphologically similar, that are called as homologous chromosomes. Or we can say that morphologically similar chromosomes which have came from the one chromosome came from the parent paternal side and one chromosome came from the maternal side. Suppose that this one is this chromosome has came from the paternal side and this one from the maternal side. So this pair is called as homologous chromosome, and the alleles which are present on the homologous type of chromosomes, it is necessary that these alleles should control the similar character. Similar types of characters are controlled by the alleles which are present on the homologous type of chromosomes. And what are homologous type of chromosomes? The chromosomes or a pair of chromosomes in which one chromosome has been coming from the father, one chromosome has been coming from the mother. And if they are morphologically similar, then that chromosomal pair or that pair of the chromosome will be called as homologous pair of chromosome. The alleles which are present on the homologous chromosome control the same character or trait. Remember this point, that the alleles which are present on the homologous chromosome, that should control the same type of character or same type of trait. Now, these were the some terminologies. Now, we will discuss the population genetics. What is population genetics? Population genetics means, it means that the study of the frequency of the genes. What is population genetics? Population genetics means that the study of the genes, or the study of the frequency of the genes in a given population, that is called as population genetics. The study of the frequency of the genes in a population, that is called as population genetics. Now, the Hardy-Weinberg law, this Hardy-Weinberg law was given by, as the name suggests, by two scientists, Hardy and another one, that is Weinberg. What does this law states? This law states that the relative frequency of the alleles of the genes, the alleles are the, we have studied here, alleles are the alternative forms of the genes. So, the relative frequency of the alleles is constant. What does this Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium states? Relative frequency of the alleles is constant from one generation to the next generation in a population where all the individuals can reproduce, or all the individuals are able to reproduce potentially. This was the statement of Hardy-Weinberg law. Stated that, Hardy-Weinberg law stated that the relative frequency of alleles, relative frequency of alleles remains constant from one generation to next generation in a given population where all the individuals can reproduce. So, this was the statement which was given by Hardy and Weinberg in their Hardy-Weinberg law, that the relative frequency of the alleles of the genes, that remain constant from one generation to the next generation in a population Why it will it will remain constant? Because it should remain constant, because when any character or when any gene is transferred from the one generation to the next generation, then due to some changes or due to the mutation or any other change, the gene frequency or the allele frequency can get disturbed. Wo disturb ho sakta hai. जब भी किसी पॉपुलेशन में कोई भी कैरेक्टर या कोई भी ट्रेट ट्रांसफर होता है फ्रॉम वन जनरेशन टू द नेक्स्ट जनरेशन, देन ड्यू टू सर्टेन चेंजेस और ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ म्यूटेशन इन दैट पॉपुलेशन, देयर इज अ चांस ऑफ द डिस्टर्बेंस ऑफ द जेनेटिक फ्रीक्वेंसी और द जीन फ्रीक्वेंसी और द अलील फ्रीक्वेंसी. बट दिस लॉ सेड दैट the allele frequency should remain constant in that population where all the organisms can reproduce potentially and where the character or the genes are being transferred from one generation to the next generation. This was the statement of the Hardy-Weinberg law. Now, to follow this statement, or this statement is applicable over certain characters, or we can say that it is applicable when certain conditions are fulfilled. What are these conditions? Conditions applicable for Hardy-Weinberg law. So, what are these conditions? The first one, that the population should be big. The first condition which this law should fulfill is that the population should be big. That is, more and more number of individuals should be present in that population so that this law will be fulfilled. The second one, organisms present in the population shows random mating. The second condition which should be fulfilled by this law is organisms in this population should show the random mating. The third one, mutation should not occur. Mutation should not occur. Why? Because agar mutation hua, to the gene frequency or the allele frequency that will get disturbed and it will not remain constant in that population, which this law have to maintain. It have to maintain the gene frequency or the allele frequency should be, it has to maintain it to the constant. But if mutation happened, agar mutation hua, to ye nahi hoga, uska frequency, that gene frequency or the allele frequency will not remain constant. The fourth one, individuals should survive and they also be reproductively potential. So, the fourth condition is individuals should survive for the longer period of time, and it should be potentially reproductive, or it should have the great reproductive power. So these were the four conditions: that population should be very big, and the second one, organisms present in the population, they should show the random mating. If they are showing the random mating, then the law will be fulfilled. The third one, there should be no mutation, and if mutation happened, then it have to be present in the both direction, that it should be the mutation will be happening in both the direction to balance the nature. And the fourth condition, that individuals should survive for the longer period of time, and they should be potentially reproductive. So these are the four conditions which should be fulfilled by the Hardy-Weinberg law. And only when this law will fulfill all these conditions, then only it will be able to maintain the gene frequency or the allele frequency up to the constant. So these were the four conditions. Now we will to understand this law more better, or to understand the equation of this law, we will now express the gene frequency, or the we will now learn about the expression of the genes or the expression of the alleles to derive this equation. Say that if we take a character A, to express that it is the dominant allele, A is the dominant allele, then AA, this will be the homozygous dominant condition. A represents the dominant allele, the single one will represent the allelic form, and the double one, it will represent the homozygously dominant condition. And this A will be represented in this equation by P, and this homozygously dominant condition, it will be represented by P square. Now, if we have taken the character small a, this will be the recessive condition, and it will be represented by Q. Double A, it will be homozygous recessive, and it will be represented by Q square. The third one, capital A and small a, this will be the third condition, heterozygous, and it will be represented in this equation as PQ. These are the expression of the alleles in this given expression, or in the Hardy-Weinberg law. Now, AA, that is homozygous dominant, homozygous recessive, and heterozygous. These are P square, Q square, and PQ. Two PQ. It is represented as two PQ. These homozygous dominant, homozygous recessive, and the heterozygous. These all these expression of alleles, they represent the gene pool for the this Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium or the Hardy-Weinberg law. They represent it or they make out a gene pool. These three expression of alleles make the gene pool. So, what will be the expression now? P square plus Q square plus 2PQ. This is the Hardy-Weinberg expression or Hardy-Weinberg law. This is the gene pool which of the Hardy-Weinberg law. And when this the gene frequency or the allele, individual allele frequency, according to the law, it will remain constant. So P square plus Q square plus 2PQ equals to 1. This is called as Hardy Weinberg law. This expression is called as Hardy-Weinberg law, in which the allele frequency, individual allele frequency, say that this remains constant even if the characters have been passed from the one generation to the next generation, then also the allele frequency should remain constant. This was about the Hardy-Weinberg law, which states that the relative frequency of the alleles should remain constant in a population, or it should remain constant from the one generation to the next generation in a population where the individuals are reproductively active or potentially reproductive. This was the statement of Hardy-Weinberg law, and this is the expression P square plus Q square plus 2PQ equals to 1. That is, the allelic frequency is constant up to the 1. Whether the traits are transmitting from the one generation to the next generation or they are not being transferred, the gene frequency or the allele frequency should remain constant. And which are the conditions that the conditions which would be fulfilled by the law, that are that the population should be the big population, that is plenty much, or the number of individuals present in the population should be very much. The second one, that organisms should show the random mating. The third one, mutation should not occur. And if the mutation happens, it should be in both the directions. And the fourth one and the last one, that is the individuals should survive for the longer period of time, and all the individuals would be potentially reproductive. Now, there are some conditions or the some factors which affect these Hardy-Weinberg principle, that if that factors are present, then the allelic frequency will not remain constant. So, we will discuss about these factors now.